మార్నింగ్ అండి. వస్తారండి, కాసేపు వెయిట్ చేయొచ్చా? జాయిన్ అవుతారండి పీపుల్, ఇంకా ఇద్దరే జాయిన్ అయ్యారు. మీ వెయిట్ ఫర్ సమ్ మోర్ టైం. Okay, we will see for a few more minutes. ఎందండి ఎవరు వచ్చేవాళ్ళు లేరా? ఇంకా మరి టూ పీపుల్ ఏనా ఇయ్యాలా? మార్నింగ్ క్లాస్ కి ఎంతమంది అటెండ్ అయ్యారు? ఏంటండి మీ ఇద్దరు కూడా ఉన్నారా లేరా? నో రిప్లై అట. మార్నింగ్ క్లాస్ జరిగింది కదండి సిఎన్ఎస్, ఎంతమంది అటెండ్ అయ్యారు? మార్నింగ్ 6. ఇప్పుడు ఆ 6లో 4 మెంబర్స్ డ్రాప్, ఓన్లీ 2 మెంబర్స్ మిగిలారు. మరి ఆవిడ కనెక్ట్ అయ్యాడు మరి డిస్కనెక్ట్ అయ్యాడు ఏమంటే. సో మనం వెయిట్ చేయటం కూడా వేస్ట్ అంటారు. ఓకే ఐ విల్ స్టార్ట్. వీడియో చూసే చూస్తారు ఈయన వాళ్ళు వింటారండి. ఐ విల్ స్టార్ట్ నౌ. See, now we have to see the Hadoop IO, which is our fourth unit. We have entered into the fourth unit where we have to see the Hadoop input and output. Clear? We have to see this one. Okay, before going to this one, I want to show you one more thing. See, when we go to the third unit, in the third unit, we have seen a sample code for the word count. For example, we have taken in the third unit, we have taken an example of word count. Word frequency. Okay, we give you a text file. In the text file, we have to find frequency of each word. For that, we have seen the sample mapper code, reducer code, and driver code. We have seen sample codes. We have seen for that one. If you observe in that sample code, we have used the following data types: long writable, text, text, int writable. Like that, we are using some data types like long writable, text, int writable. Okay, we are using some data types like that. What is this long writable? What is this text? What is this int writable? We have to know about that one in the mapper code or in the reducer code. We are using that one here also. In the reducer code also, we have used text comma int writable comma text comma int writable. Like that we are using. Okay, normally what are the data types we know? We know only integer, float, double, char. Okay, short, long, like that. But here we are using the data types like this: text, int writable, etc. What are these data types? Okay, that's we have to learn in this fourth unit Hadoop IO. We have to learn about that one. Okay, the aim of this unit is, in this unit we have to learn about that Hadoop input and output. What is this Hadoop input and output? Okay, that's what we want to know. Okay, this unit is completely about the writable data types of Hadoop. We will see what are the writable data types of Hadoop, what are their use, how we can use them. Okay, see, the Hadoop data types are called as the writables. The Hadoop data types are called as the writables. So we have to slowly learn about this, completely about this writable data types of Hadoop and its importance. Okay, at the beginning itself we can't understand these about completely about these writables. Slowly when we going on inside, we will completely understand about these writables. Okay, first topic is we have to learn about what is this writables, what is their importance in Hadoop. Okay, see, writable is an interface in Hadoop. I think you have an idea about the interface. Okay, writable is an interface in Hadoop. Okay, I think you have some idea about the interfaces. Okay, we will discuss again interface in this class itself. We will discuss separately about the interface. Here, writable is an interface in the Hadoop. Okay, writable interface in Hadoop is similar to the wrapper classes in Java. We know in Java, for every data, primary primitive data type, wrapper class is available. Okay, the writable interface in Java will play the same role as wrapper classes of Java. Okay, what are the role of wrapper classes in Java? The similar role is played by the writable interface of Hadoop. Clear? We will learn about this wrapper class also. We will discuss now itself. Briefly, we will discuss about that wrapper class also. So first thing is, writable is an interface and its role is similar to wrapper classes in Java. Clear? For example, if int data type is there in Java, okay,
In Hadoop, how do we write the same int data type means? When we come to Hadoop, we write that int data type as int writable. Okay, when we take int data type of Java, we will write here in Hadoop as int writable. We will learn completely about all the data types. Just for example, he given here. Okay, how we write int of Java is in Hadoop means int writable. Okay, string of Java. Whenever we want to take the string data type of Java, in Hadoop, in the place of string data type, we take the data type text in place of string. Okay, that's why when we go to the previous class, in the reducer code, we are using text here. In the place of string data type, he used here text. In the place of int data type, he used the int writable. Int writable means here the data type is int. Text means here the data type is string. But in the Hadoop, instead of the string int like that, we are using int writable, text, etc. Okay, that is the point we have to consider in this one. Okay. What are the use of this writable means? Okay, the writable data types are used for creating serialized data types in Hadoop. We will learn completely next what is this serialized data type. We will understand in the next class. Okay, the use of this writables is the main use of the writable interface in the Hadoop is to create serialized data types in Hadoop. Slowly we will understand about that one later. Okay, writable is an interface. It is similar to upper classes in Java. Okay, for every data type in Java, Hadoop contains the another data type which is implemented by the writable interface. For example, int is given as int writable, string is given as text, like that. The main use of these writables in Java in Hadoop is for creating serialized data types. The use of this writable interface is to create the serialized data types in Hadoop. Briefly, before going to the Hadoop writable data types, we will recall the Java concepts. First of all, what is a data type? In the C language onwards, we are learning the data type, C, C++, Python, Java. Everywhere we are using the data types. What is a data type means? A data type is simply, a data type is a thing which will tell the type of data. A data type indicates what type of data we are going to handle. Okay, data type will indicate what type of data a variable is going to store, whether it is going to store integer data or float data or character data or Boolean values like that. A data type is a set of data with values having predefined characteristics. It has some predefined characteristics. Okay, set of data with values having a predefined characteristics. Integer data type means it will store only integer values. Float data type means it will store only float values like that. Okay, when we come to the Java, how many data types are there? When we come to Java, the primitive data types are there. Okay, how many are there means? Anybody know how many primitive data types are there in Java? How many primitive data types are available in Java? Can anybody answer? Eight primitive data types are there. What are those eight? Byte, short, int, long. First four are byte, short, int, long. These four belongs to the category of integer. Next, float, double. These two belongs to the floating point category. Next, char belongs to the character type. Next, Boolean. Okay. First four are byte, short, long, int, long. Next, float, double. Next, char and Boolean. Eight primitive data types are there in. What is the default integer data type in Java? What is the default integer data type in Java? For integer category, four data types are there. Byte, short, int, long. What is the default one? Anybody have any other answer? What is the default integer data type? Dynamically cheppodandi, if you know, tell the answer. Int is the default data type of in Java. For integer category, what is the default data type in Java means? Int is the default data type for integer category. What is the default data type in case of floating point data types in Java? For floating point in Java, two primitive data types are there, float and double. What is the default one among those two? Sorry, double is the default one. Okay, When we come to floating point category, in case of Java, double is the default data type. Similarly, when we come to the integer category, int is the default data type. Clear? So that is the thing. 8 primitive data types are there. Those are the 8. One important point when we have to consider in case of the Java data types is string is not a direct data type in Java. String is not a primitive data type in Java. String is a wrapper class. String is a class in Java. Clear? Generally, what we will say is like in C or C++, we will consider string also as a data type here also. But when we come to the Java, string is not a directly data type. In the primitive 8 data types, we don't have string, only char is there. String is a class, or not is not a data type. Okay, that is the thing. Several kinds of data types are available in Java. Here he has given some examples. Clear? These data types are called the primitive data types, basic data types. These are the basic data type. Okay, for every primitive data type, okay, for these primitive data types, classes are available, predefined classes are available in Java for these 8 primitive data types. Those classes are called the wrapper classes. Clear? For all these primitive data types, separate classes are available in Java. Those are called the wrapper classes. What is the use of importance of these wrapper classes? See, Java has 8 primitive data types are there. These 8 primitive data types are not objects. They are ordinary data types only. They are not the objects. But when we come to the Java, since Java is pure object-oriented programming language, most of the concepts in Java want objects, not the ordinary values. They want the objects. Most of the concepts in Java want the objects instead of the ordinary values. But these 8 primitive data types, which we have discussed previously, are only ordinary data types. They are not the objects. But most of the concepts doesn't want the ordinary data types. They want the objects. How to get objects for these primitive data types? Since they are not directly objects, okay, for these primitive classes, data types, okay, wrapper classes are created. For every primitive data type, separate wrapper class is available in Java. Okay, so by using this wrapper class, we can create the object for that data type. We can create the object for that data type. Okay, for int, what is the wrapper class? Integer is the wrapper class for int. Similarly, what is the wrapper class for short? Short, short, S is capital class name. Short is the wrapper class for primitive data type short. Byte has byte. For byte, we have byte. Same name with capital letter. Byte, byte, long, long. Okay, double, double. Data type is all the characters are small letters. When we come to the wrapper class, first letter is capital. For a double, data type is double, small letters. When we come to the wrapper class, first D is capital. Okay, like that. For 8 primitive data types, 8 wrapper classes are available in Java. What is the why wrapper classes are used in Java? I mean, most of the concepts in Java using the will use only objects. They don't want the ordinary data types, they want the object. Since primitive data types are not directly objects, to create objects for the primitive data types, wrapper classes are defined. They are called the wrapper classes. Clear? Like that. That is the briefly about the first thing, data types in Java, primitive data types in Java. Just we are recalling that one. Why? Because we have to convert these primitive data types in Java to Hadoop data types. So we are recalling that one. All these wrapper classes are predefined in the Java wrapper class. We have no need to write the wrapper classes. They are predefined in Java. I think in the first unit already we discussed. One big data first unit logo discussed just briefly. We have discussed about the wrapper classes. Next, we have to recall the interface concept also. Can anybody define what is an interface? I think in the C++, Python, Java, we have discussed the interfaces. Three languages lo vachayi interfaces. Can anybody define? An interface is an abstract type means. Yeah, exactly. Very good. Interface is similar to class, but is an abstract type. That means an interface contains only abstract methods. An interface is similar to that of the class. But the difference between class and interface is class will contain both concrete methods and abstract methods, but interface will contain only abstract methods. So before understanding interface, we have to understand what is a abstract method, what is concrete method or non-abstract method. Methods are two types, abstract methods, non-abstract methods or concrete methods. Abstract methods means methods which are defined but not declared. Methods which are declared but not defined are known as, but not implemented, are known as abstract method. Only when I declare this, but we have not given its logic. For example, we given void add of empty parenthesis, we have given no body at all. Just we have defined the method name as void add. We have not given any body. That method is known as the abstract method. Why? Because it does not have any body. It does not know what to do. Just the name of the method is declared. I am using void add method. But what to do with that add method? Logic is not given. That method is called abstract method. When we come to the concrete method, the methods which are declared and defined, methods which are declared as well as defined are known as concrete method. That means we declare the method name as well as we define the logic of that method. Body of the method is also given. Void add insight into a is equal to 5, into b is equal to 5, c is equal to a plus b, system dot out dot println display c. That means we are defining what to do with that method. A method range arrow man cheptunnam. We are declaring as well as defining the method. That is called concrete method or non-abstract method. The method which is defined but not, or which is declared but not defined, is known as abstract method. A class can contain general classes. Generally, we write many classes we are writing. The classes we are writing can contain concrete methods. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Along with the concrete method, sometimes we have to write abstract method classes. We have to write sometimes along with the ordinary classes. Sometimes we have to write the abstract classes. What is an abstract class means? An abstract class is a class which contains both concrete methods and abstract methods. The class which contains only concrete method is known as ordinary class. The class which contains both concrete methods and abstract methods is known as abstract class. And the third category is interface. The class which does not contain, which contains only abstract methods, is known as interface. Three categories are there: ordinary class, abstract class, interface. Ordinary class contains only concrete methods. Abstract class contains both concrete methods and abstract methods. An interface contains only abstract method. An interface is similar to a class which contains only abstract methods. That means only methods are declared but not defined. Without body, we define the method. Such method classes are called the interfaces. What is the use of interface in Java? By using interface in Java, what is the main advantage of using interfaces in Java? One of important uses cheptunnanandi. Java does not support. Very good. Directly, Java does not support the multiple inheritance. So, to implement multiple inheritance, we are using the concept of interfaces. Directly, abstract classes does not support the Java classes does not directly support multiple inheritance. So, in that place, to support multiple inheritance, we are using interfaces. Exactly, very good answer. Okay, that is briefly about the interfaces in Java. See the points about interfaces in Java. An interface is a complete abstract class. That means which contains completely abstract methods. Clear? The methods are within an interface are abstract methods which does not accept body. And the abstract methods are public, static, and final. The methods in the abstract in the interface are by default abstract methods are public, static, and final. What is the use of the keyword? Java lo final keyword em cheptundi? What is the use of final keyword? Final keyword deniki use chestanu Java lo? Public keyword, static keyword, and final. What he is saying is the methods in the interface are by default public, static, and final. I by default the interface lo unde methods anni public methods, static methods, and final methods antnadu. What is the meaning of that public, static, and final? Keywords are meaning enti. Yeah, final means cannot be modified. Okay. To declare them as a constant. Further, we can't modify. Okay. Static means they are by default. See, final means they are cannot be modified. Okay. What is this static keyword in meaning? What is this public tells? మన పబ్లిక్ స్టాటిక్ వైడ్ మెయిన్ అని చెప్పి మెయిన్ మెథడ్కి ఎప్పుడు రాస్తున్నాం పబ్లిక్ స్టాటిక్ వైడ్ మెయిన్ ఇక్కడ స్టాటిక్ ఏం చెప్తుంది పబ్లిక్ ఏం చెప్తుంది ఫైనల్ ఇండికేట్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏ కాన్స్టెంట్ దట్ మీన్స్ విచ్ వి కెనాట్ బి మాడిఫైడ్ అసలు దాంట్లో బాడీనే లేదు మనం మాడిఫై చేయడానికి స్టాటిక్ కాన్స్టెంట్ కాదండి ఫైనల్ కీవర్డ్ ఫర్ స్టాటిక్ కాన్స్టెంట్ వాల్యూస్ ఫైనల్ కీవర్డ్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఇండికేట్స్ ద కాన్స్టెంట్ వాల్యూస్ దట్ మీన్స్ వి కెనాట్ మాడిఫై స్టాటిక్ డస్ నాట్ రిలేటెడ్ టు కాన్స్టెంట్ వాల్యూస్ స్టాటిక్ ఏం చెప్తుంది ఎనీబడి మనం పబ్లిక్ స్టాటిక్ వైడ్ మెయిన్ రాస్తున్నామండి మన అందులో పబ్లిక్ స్టాటిక్ ఏం చెబుతున్నాయి రేపు ఏదైనా జావాలో ఇంటర్వ్యూ క్వశ్చన్ ఫస్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ జరుగుతాడండి వాట్ ఇస్ ద ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ పబ్లిక్ స్టాటిక్ వైడ్ మెయిన్ అని అందులో మనం ఎప్పుడు అందుకే మనం తెలిసి ఉండాలి పబ్లిక్ స్టాటిక్ ఏం చేస్తాయి జావాలో ఏ ప్రోగ్రామ్ రాసినా మీరు ఈ రెండు కీవర్డ్స్ ఏదో ప్రతి దాంట్లో రాస్తున్నారు పబ్లిక్ స్టాటిక్ వైడ్ మెయిన్ కాదండి వేరియబుల్ మెథడ్ కాదు ఫిక్స్డ్ కాదు సి మనం జావా చదువుకున్నాం అయిపోయింది జావాలో మీరు ఒక 10 ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ రాసుకుంటే ప్రతి ప్రోగ్రామ్ లో రాసి ఉంటారు ఎందుకంటే మెయిన్ మెథడ్ లేకుండా జావా ప్రోగ్రామ్ రాయలేం కాబట్టి నో వాట్ ఈస్ ద యూజ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ పబ్లిక్ కీవర్డ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద యూజ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్ స్టాటిక్స్ రిమెంబర్ గుర్తుపెట్టుకున్నాను ఎప్పుడైనా స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్ ఎందుకు యూజ్ చేస్తామంటే ఇఫ్ యూ యూజ్ స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్ బిఫోర్ ఎనీ మెథడ్ నేమ్ దట్ మెథడ్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ స్టాటిక్ మెథడ్ ఇఫ్ యూ యూజ్ స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్ బిఫోర్ ఎనీ మెథడ్ దెన్ దట్ మెథడ్ ఈస్ నోన్ యాజ్ ద స్టాటిక్ మెథడ్ ద బెనిఫిట్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టాటిక్ మెథడ్స్ ఈస్ వీ కెన్ కాల్ ద స్టాటిక్ మెథడ్స్ వితౌట్ యూజింగ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ వై వీ ఆర్ మేకింగ్ మెథడ్స్ యాజ్ స్టాటిక్ మీన్స్ ఇఫ్ యూ మేక్ ఎనీ మెథడ్ యాజ్ అ స్టాటిక్ వితౌట్ క్రియేటింగ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ వీ కెన్ కాల్ దోస్ మెథడ్స్ Static methods can be called without creating object. Generally, when we come to Java, if there is instance method, the instance can be method can be called only by using object of that class. Whenever we have the static method, we can call that method without using the object also. Clear? Static keyword is used to make the method as a static method. When we use static keyword before any method, that method will become static method. Static method means that method can be called without creating object. మీరు ఆబ్జెక్ట్ క్రియేట్ చేసైనా కాల్ చేయొచ్చు ఆబ్జెక్ట్ లేకుండా కూడా వీ కెన్ కాల్ దట్ మెథడ్ దట్ ఈస్ ద యూజ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్ క్లియర్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్ ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్ నెక్స్ట్ పబ్లిక్ కీవర్డ్ ఈ పబ్లిక్ కీవర్డ్ ఏం చెబుతుంది స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్ ఒక రఫ్ ఐడియా వచ్చిందండి వాట్ ఈస్ ద యూజ్ ఆఫ్ ది స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్ పబ్లిక్ కీవర్డ్ ఒక క్లాస్ ముందు కానీ ఒక మెథడ్ ముందు కానీ పబ్లిక్ పెడితే ఏమవుతుంది సీ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ మేకింగ్ ఎనీ క్లాస్ ఆర్ మెథడ్ యాజ్ పబ్లిక్ ఓకే ఎనీ అవుట్ సైడ్ పర్సన్ కెన్ యాక్సెస్ దట్ వన్ డైరెక్ట్లీ ఇఫ్ యు మేక్ ద మెథడ్స్ ఆర్ క్లాసెస్ యాజ్ పబ్లిక్ మీన్స్ ఇఫ్ యు మేడ్ ఇట్ యాజ్ ఎ పబ్లిక్ అవుట్ సైడ్ పర్సన్ కెన్ యాక్సెస్ ద మెథడ్ ఈజీలీ ఓకే without any restrictions the outside person can happily access the method andukene manam public static void main void main mundu main method mundu eppudu c lo chuste meeru void main rasaru c c++ lo kan java ku vachapudu public static void main rasnam void tho paatu public static enduku rasnam ante main method ni execute aitene object create aithi java program lo object create avvalante mundu main method execute avvali mari object lekunda main method ela execute avvali daniki kosam manam main method ni em chestunnam ante స్టాటిక్ చేస్తున్నాము సిన్స్ మెయిన్ మెథడ్ ఈ స్టాటిక్ జేవిఎం కెన్ డైరెక్ట్లీ కాల్ ద మెయిన్ మెథడ్ వితౌట్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ దట్ ఈస్ ద ఫస్ట్ పాయింట్ వై వీఆర్ మేకింగ్ ద మెయిన్ మెథడ్ స్టాటిక్ మీన్స్ విత్ మెయిన్ మెథడ్ క్రియేట్ అయితేనే మనకు ఆబ్జెక్ట్ క్రియేట్ అయ్యేది జావాలో మరి ఆబ్జెక్ట్ క్రియేట్ అవ్వకముందు మెయిన్ మెథడ్ని కాల్ చేయాలంటే ఎలా అంటే సో వీఆర్ మేకింగ్ ద మెయిన్ మెథడ్ యాజ్ స్టాటిక్ సిన్స్ మెయిన్ మెథడ్ ఈ స్టాటిక్ మెథడ్ జేవిఎం కెన్ డైరెక్ట్లీ కాల్ ద మెయిన్ మెథడ్ వితౌట్ క్రియేటింగ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ వితౌట్ యూజ్ ఆఫ్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ That is the one thing. Next, why we are making public means? main method public enduku chestunnam ante if we make any method as a public that method can be directly called by the outside person directly if we make any method as a public that method can be directly called by the outside person directly without any restriction JVM is outside your program JVM is not part of your program JVM is outside the program how JVM will call the main method it is outside the program how it will call means so we are giving access rights as public since the main method is public anyone outside the program can directly call the main method generally we have the in java 4 access specifiers are there public private protected default if we don't write anything default access specifier will be there if we write public private or protected we have to write okay public means outside person can directly access the inner methods without any restrictions that's why to allow JVM to directly call the main method we are making a main method as public and static with the help of these two keywords JVM is able to happily access the main method that is the importance of public static void main id important question eppudu manam marchipogudu endukante java meeda question ante vallu first adiga question ide andi meer eppudu padugulu rastane prathi program ga rastunnaru kada deeni ok usage enti damn sure adugutaru aa question ni adi basic question clear next one point about the interface is the structure of interface is similar to that of a class adu mana telisina point endi next important point about the interface is we can't create an object for an interface okay for a class we can create object but for an interface we can't create object this is another an important point for interfaces we are unable to create the object then how to access the methods of the interface generally what we know is if there is a class by creating object to that class we are accessing that interfaces now what he is saying is for interface we can't create an object object cannot be created for interfaces then how to act how to use efficiently use the interface means we can the only way to use the interface is to implement that interface in other classes by using the keyword implements with the help of the keyword implements okay we implement an interface by using another class that is called inheritance interface A we take interface A will have some method we okay class B will inherit interface A using implements class B implements interface A and it can use the methods of interface A clear for example it will be like this we have interface A as interface contains only the abstract method I am writing void add up okay this is the interface here it contains the add method now how to use this interface means if we are unable to create object for this interface here how to use this interface means I will take another class class B is c cap small attorney class B implements A here I will use that name void add up whatever the logic I want write I will write the logic sorry and s of s dot o dot p of c if you observe this one this is the interface okay we have taken the interface the interface contains only final next to use this method, how to use this myriad method, since it is interface, we can't create object to this interface. How to implement this one means we can implement this one with the help of another class. We take another class, class B, which is implement A. By using the keyword implement, we are implementing that methods of interface. Okay, that is he is saying, we can't create an object for an interface, and the only way to use the interface is to implement it in another class by using the implements keyword. That is the basic thing. What are the data types in Java? Briefly we have seen. Next, what are the interfaces in Java? That is briefly we have seen. Clear? Next class we will see about the serialization and deserialization in Java. Before going to the writable data types in Hadoop, we want to know one more thing. Next class we have to know about what is Java serialization. Okay, before starting the Hadoop data types, we have to recollect all these things, then only we can easily understand the Hadoop writable data type. That's why we are refreshing this knowledge. Why we are refreshing Java concepts? To understand the Hadoop writable data types, we want this one. Tomorrow we will briefly refresh about data serialization in Java, then we will go for the writable data types of Hadoop. We will go to the writable data types in Hadoop later. Clear? This is briefly about the today's class. Tomorrow we will meet with the Java serialization concept. Okay guys. Meanwhile, for tomorrow you have to do one small thing. Those who are interested, you have to do one thing. Please recollect about the importance of public keyword, public static void main. ఒకసారి రీకలెక్ట్ చేసుకోండి, మీరు నెట్ లో చదవండి. వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ పబ్లిక్ స్టాటిక్ వైడ్ మెయిన్, ఒకటి. నెక్స్ట్, వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్. స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్ యూజెస్ ఉన్నాయి, చాలా యూజెస్ ఉన్నాయి. స్టాటిక్ బ్లాక్, ఇన్స్టెన్స్ బ్లాక్ అనేది స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్, ఫైనల్ కీవర్డ్. ఓకే, వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ స్టాటిక్ కీవర్డ్ యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ ద ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫైనల్ కీవర్డ్. ఒకసారి బ్రీఫ్ గా చదువుకోండి వీటి గురించి నెట్ లో. మీ దగ్గర జావా మెటీరియల్ ఉంటే జావా మెటీరియల్ లో కానీ ఏదైనా లేదా డైరెక్ట్ గూగుల్లో మనకు దొరుకుతూనే ఉంది. వి హావ్ టు రీకలెక్ట్ దట్ వన్. ఒక్కసారి రీకలెక్ట్ చేసుకోండి. క్లియర్? విచ్ విల్ బి యూస్ఫుల్ ఫర్ ద ఫ్యూచర్ క్లాసెస్. ఫ్యూచర్ లో మీకు యూజ్ అవుతూ ఉంటుందండి. అలాగే ఇంటర్ఫేసెస్ గురించి జస్ట్ రీకాల్ దట్ వన్. క్లియర్? టుమారో వి విల్ మీట్ విత్ ద కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ సిరిలైజేషన్. ఓకే, థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్. ఫర్ టుడే ఐఎమ్ వైండింగ్ అప్. ఓన్లీ 1 మినిట్ ఈస్ లెఫ్ట్, సో ఐఎమ్ వైండింగ్ అప్ నౌ. టుమారో వి విల్ మీట్ విత్ serialization concept of Java. Thank you very much.